Hello everyone, JRR here, and today we're going over a movie review. The Princess Blade, as opposed to the princess named Blade. Because, you know, some motherfuckers are always trying to ice skate uphill. No, this has nothing to do with Wesley Snipes' flick, or the comic of Blade, which I believe is Marvel, if memory serves correctly. And yeah, I'm wearing a DC shirt, go figure. Anyway! Princess Blade is about a clan of ex-royal guards who, through circumstances, were hunted by the government after the monarch was overthrown, and they put their skills on the market, which pretty much means they would kill anyone they were paid to kill. It's a long pre-story that they put up there, and I'm just trying to save you guys time from having to sit there and go through the scrolling. It does tend to dragon points. No, not dragon points. Like flying through the air, sharp teeth, fangs, claws, fire from the sky. No, not that. I mean, it kind of drags on. They have a lot of story to try to put in there to space out the action. So what I've done was summarize most of it so you guys don't have to worry about the slow side of things. You're welcome. Now, with that being said, let us go ahead and go through our introduction to the assassins. They're about as subtle as a truck. Notice there's like two female assassins and a bunch of guys. Well, the younger female assassin has mommy issues. Now, what do I mean by mommy issues? Well, her mom kind of got murdered. Killed. Offed. She got gotten. Well, this actually becomes a thing for plot B. Oh, there is a plot B. Don't worry about that. Plot A. Let me speed up plot A for you.
タケミカズチを逃げ出した者は裏切り者。裏切り者は秘密を売る。
なんかは仕込んだ山を越える気だ。だがあいつの足ではまだ鉱山跡まではたどり着いていない。ユキ、キリを連れて行け。
一人で行きます。
僕行きますよ。
足手まといです。
なんだ、ユキか。丸腰だぞ。切るな、ユキ。切るな。ユキ、な、頼む。刀持ってけ。
殺したことにしといてくれ。頼む。ね。
Alright, to get to plot B, we have to get plot A rolling, and...
なるほど。ユキはもう私の叶う相手じゃないん
だ。誰だ？
私の名はクーカ。あなたの母にお使い申したものだ。あなたに告げなければならないことがある。あなたの母を殺した者のことだ。襲撃の折に殺されたと聞いてると思うが、あなたの母を殺したのは白雷だ。
嘘つけ。母は…
あなたの母、竹見が土の姫、アゾラ様を殺したのは白雷だ。仇を討つなら一族継承の座を取れ。討たぬなら住処を去れ。ユキ様は明日で二十歳。本来なら明日からは雪姫として竹見和地を治める身の上。一族を抜け出すか、一族継承者の座を取るか、いずれかの道を選ぶんだ。
あんかは命乞いをしたか。
母は命乞いをしたのか。
何の話だ。
声が揺れている。気が乱れている。
自分のしていることが分かっているのか。
自らの口で言え。白雷、あなたが母を殺したのか。
違う。
竹見和地を裏切って逃げようとした。だから殺されたんだ。
嘘だ。
ブラキ、そんなに気合いやってちゃ何も切れんぞ。
Like I just showed with the clip. Like I just showed. English. Like I just shown with the clip. Old man shows up. There's a little bit of a dialogue. And apparently she's going to meet the old man later to find out the truth about her mom. Now, most of you probably realize the same thing I realized. One, if she leaves the clan, if she just leaves them, then she'll be hunted down and killed. Right. Two, if she plans to take over the clan, or take her rightful place in the clan, she'll have to deal with the leader, which possibly means he's going to have the clan try to kill her. Right. So in both cases, the clan's going to try to kill her. Right. So, with that being said, we need to get this... Now that we've got plot A going, we need to get this attached somehow to plot B, because, you know, most... any type of story like this has to have a sort of love interest. So, you gotta have a plot B. And plot B happens to be a guy this time. Yay! So, maybe certain groups will shut the... I want to be nice. I want to be nice. Gonna leave that out. I want to be nice. Gonna be nice. Because we all know no movies or video games ever have female leads. I'm gonna be nice. I'm gonna be nice. Let us continue to plot B. Well, let's get plot A to meet plot B, and then we can go with plot B and get some stuff going.
あや、どうした？これで俺を殺しに来たのか。お前、竹見和寿の人間だろ。誰に雇われた。言えよ。仲間が来んのか。
誰も来ない。お前を殺しに来たわけじゃない。
嘘つけ。そんなこと信用できると思うか。
信じろ。
信じろ。子供だろうが何だろうが金詰まりりゃ皆殺しにするような人間だお前らは。信用したら最後殺されちゃうよ。
殺そうと思ったらもう殺してる。でも殺さない。信用したか。
久しぶりだな、居所だ。帰ってきた。それに会って話をしたいことがある。今日そこに行く。
So there is a little chemistry there. And who do you trust? Money. No. But she has money, probably would help. But I'm just saying, it would help. Anyway, she goes back out there to, well, she's plot A. She has to deal with plot A. And she does go and find the old man, whose stealth is... Stealth is
ケミカズ家の血を継ぐ一人娘アドラ様には誓い合った男がいた。一族に忠誠を誓ったものだったが、白雷はその男を謀反人に仕立てて殺した。
やっぱりお前か、グーか。
ソーマか。大きくなったもんだな。
お許しいただく。
Like a freaking dog. Why didn't anyone swing at the time? You throw, swing, sword. It done. Game over. No more movie. No. He threw her. And then the other girl just runs over there and kicks her anyway. It's like, eh, get down. So, I'm gonna say this. Like I told Tack when he was taking on the lead character, And like I told Tak again, when he was the lead character and he was up against the big boss, who was literally catching bullets, run, bitch! Run! Get out there! Get out! So, she went one on one with the other lady, and why not? This isn't that kind of movie, guys. Even though there's a couple moments I'm pretty sure y'all were questioning that. Huh. Que sera, sera. Alright, anyway. After she escapes the group, because apparently no one was going to chase after her. Okay. She gets back to Mr. Plot B and starts recovery. And because...
おい、くそ、どっから出てんだよ。
You know, holding a hand doesn't exactly make it for sword fighting. So, while that's going on, we'll go ahead and get some of the chunks out the way. Let's see, what do we need to cover? What do we need to cover? You know what? While I get a list of things that we actually need to cover, we'll go ahead and show the little montage of them getting along and all that happy stuff. So, clip, just, no, just something. No, none of that? Okay, well, whenever the clip decides to pop up, it'll pop up. I'll get a list of things.
食べろよ。タンパク質がないとお前傷治んねえぞ。妹が8歳の時、俺が学校から帰ると家中血だらけだった。妹だけが生きてた。やった奴らはすぐに捕まったけど、証拠は十分で無罪になった。だから俺はそいつらを自分の手で殺したんだ。俺は捕まって裁判にかけられ、懲役を食らった。4年経って出てみたら、もう俺は昔みたいに世の中を見ることができなくなってた。何もかもすっかり変わって見えた。そんな時ある人に出会った。その人は俺に昔の幸せを取り戻そうって言ってくれた。そう言ってくれたのはあの人だけだった。 いろんなことしたよ。いろんなことさせられたし、幸せだった頃に戻りたくて何もかも正当化してたんだ。
ねえ、
ん？
ミティ氏って知ってる？
知らない。
美しく尊い石って書いてミティ氏。めったに落ちないんだ。一生懸命探しても一年に一個見つかればいいってくらい。でもそれを刀の砥石で磨いていくと小さな緑色の石晶になるの。母さんそれをずっと集めてて、見つけてはゆっくり時間をかけて磨いて貯めてたんだ。それを30個集めて首飾りを作ろうとしてたんだって。私が結婚するまでに。私の結婚する日にそれを私にかけるって言って、母さん18歳からそれを集め出して22で私を産んで27で殺された。死んだ時、母さんが大切に持ってた箱の中に石晶になったミティ石が9つ入ってた。首飾りにするにはだいぶ足らなかったけど、もうすぐ私は母さんが私を産んだ年を超えて、母さんが死んだ年も超える。でも私は誰かに残せるものなんてまだ一つも集めてない。何かを残してあげられる人だって私にはいない。私には大切にしたいと思う人なんて誰もいない。
ここを出よう。 緒にこの国を出よう。こんなとこにこだわってとどまる必要なんかないんだよ。今までのこと綺麗に忘れて生きられる場所はきっとある。
Now that I got my list. I got my list. I got my list. There was a song out there, and I'm going to be linking it with the whole Batman thing I have on my RPA. That is coming out, don't worry. Still gotta edit it. But there's a line that was taken from, I think it's Death Clock or something like that, from their Mermaider song. It's something about, now I'm not using the exact line, but it's the general premise of the line. Even if you get vengeance, someone will seek vengeance upon you. In fact, it was brought up in Izumi. You kill somebody, but that person's friends will come to kill you, and then your friends will come to kill them, and then their friends will come and kill that guy. You get the idea. It's a never-ending cycle. It's constant. It's always going. In a few other movies, that's why one of the guys would always state, there will be no revenge. This is just 1-1. This is it. Because if you don't state that kind of shit, things will just cycle around. I digress. Because she killed the other girl, you know what's going to happen. So cut.
Thank you.
Hi. どうしても伺いたいことがあるんですが。
なんだ。
我々は本当にユキを殺してしまっていいんでしょうか。ユキを失ったら竹見和地直系の血を継ぐ者がいなくなります。そうなったら我々は。
だからなんだ。すでに竹見和地の血なんてものは失われている。
しかし竹見和地の生で失っては我々は何を支え
るの。支えなんか必要ない。我々には守るべきものもない。
Good news, and there's bad news. The good news, this guy has a little IQ. A little bit of IQ. Just a little brain power. He knows something is up. He knows something will happen. He knows something is going to go down. So, with that being said, he wants to... Well, I have him stated. But because he wants to do it, she's not exactly fully ready because she isn't sure and... Well, she's got to go out and think about it. Now, plot A and plot B have this whole thing where you could tell they're going to be separated for their conclusions. You could tell that right from the get-go. So, with that being said, and with his battle plan, let's go ahead and have this whole one big stream. That's just one big shot. Just one shot. One shot. Let's just... Do the ending scene. Boom. Just do the ending scene. We'll be done. We'll cover everything. I put in final words. Get anything else out the way. Bada boom, bada bing.
お母さん。私。嬉しかった。
お前に幸せな日が来ると思ってるのか。たとえ俺を倒してもお前の行く道は修羅の道だ。 その道を逃れることはできない。
木所さん、妹さん元気そうだね。何の用ですか？この間送ってもらった図面のことなら。
いや、あれはもういい。計画を変えた。しかも素晴らしい計画だよ。高志なら賛成してくれるだろう。
何ですか？
連邦府と妥協できる部分は折り合いをつける。犠牲者を最小限にとどめられるし、しかも我々の理想も叶えられる。どうだ高志、いい案だろう。 取引だよ。方法を厭わなければ理想は叶えられる。
裏切りじゃないか。
我々の精神は失われてない。この間図面を送った計画でみんな終わらせるつもりだった。
あれを利用して俺たちごと殺すつもりだったのか。
人聞きの悪いこと言うな高志。まあ仮にそうなってもお前も本望だろう。
それであんたは政府に身を置いて助かる気か。
だから取引だって言ってるだろう。取引をしたんだよ。
今までやってきたことは無駄かよ。あんなに犠牲を出したのは何だったんだよ。
意味はあったよ。みんな理想を信じてやったことだ。
みんなはあんたを信じてここまでやってきたんじゃないか。真鍋が撃ち殺されたのも、和樹が拷問されて死んだのも、三村が爆死したのも、全部あんたを信じてやってきたんじゃないか。あんたが幸せを取り戻そうって言ってくれたから、あんただけがそう言ってくれたからじゃねえか。
幸福な世界は来るよ。もちろんただじゃ来ない。言ったら代償は高い。犠牲者には冥福を祈るしかない。ただしお前は祈ってる場合ではないぞ、隆。お前も祈られる犠牲者の一人なんだ。
てめえ。
Okay.
Yeah, I went ahead and stopped it right here. For those of you who've kept up with my little roleplay aids and where I brought in scenes from movies to help explain my points better by example, I'm going to go ahead and let you know now. This moment, if you have emotions, you might want to go ahead and switch them off right about now. If you're worried about them feels, you might want to go ahead and switch those off right about now. Because this is some bullshit.
Ah!
You know, at the beginning of this movie, something about a girl's name was throwing me off, and it was pissing me off, because I know I've seen it somewhere, I've heard it before, it just, it's not clicking. Ah, freaking knew it. She's known for her smile. That's why she very rarely smiled this damn movie, because she was known for her smile. And, ah, ha, 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 ha. Ha. Okay, then. Well, with all that said, at least she will have time to think about what she's going to do now, because now she's got a murder house, and her clan pretty much got eviscerated by her, so, yeah. Happy ending for her! Happy, happy, happy ending for her. Happy ending. You see, this is the shit why I didn't do it live. Because the final decision isn't exactly ambiguous. Especially when putting all the facts together, it's not exactly ambiguous. But, yeah. Anyway, what do I think of the movie? Well, like I said at the beginning, whichever way the beginning was, I don't know. Slider down here will tell you where the beginning was at. But like I said at the beginning, it does drag on at points because it wants to make sure you have extra character development. And when I said turn off your feels, whatever, if it didn't hit you at all, that's because I took a lot of stuff out. Duh. But let me stress, the movie itself, action-wise, it's pretty good. Like I said, I showed y'all the final scene in general, so you got it. So you got to see a great combat scene. At the beginning, I showed you the opening scene because it was a great combat scene. I showed you these because the movie itself has very solid story, and yeah, there may be plot holes, but it's not as massive as, say, many other movies. And they do try to wrap everything up. You know, just like maybe 3 to 4 of the clan running out without Princess Yuki here. So you know there's at least 3 to 4 assassins by themselves that are of the line. And then there's Princess Yuki herself. So if she really wanted to get the clan started, again, she can go and do that. Highly doubt it. But I know some of you are thinking, well, what about that other asshole with the gum and the gun and all that? Well, clearly he's going to get away because Yuki didn't know about him. So she can't kill him, unless she takes a specific job that says, kill him. But anyway, the movie itself is pretty good. It's a fair sit through if you were, I can't say bored. It actually has a little bit more mind power than just being bored. So you do have to pay a little bit of attention. I summarized it pretty quick here, so I want y'all to go ahead and have some fun. Have yourselves a good day. I do recommend this movie. It is good for the action. Again, the story's a little bit long, but that can't be helped. I mean, with my videos, they're usually very long, so what the fuck ever. So, I'm JRR. I'm out. And y'all have fun. And I'm going to go back to watching stuff like Wrongfully Accused and Airplane or some shit. That was depressing as fuck. Depressing. And the girl fights all those people just to have her boyfriend die. What the fuck ever. That's not fair. How's that a happy ending?